Hello, I'm Oddball, and welcome back to the Media Dimension. Today, we're playing Sailor Moon Part 40, which means I am not finishing it this in the 10 episodes I thought it would take me to do this in. Oh well. Que sera, sera. So, with that, today's episode revolves around us looking for the 5 crystal points around Crystal Tokyo. Same thing goes here, make sure your team's in the right formation. Yada yada yada. These crystal points are so big you really can't miss them, they're giant crystals jutting out of the ground. Also, with a bit of grinding, you can actually get rid of all the hot zone enemies within one time stop. That's very helpful. It's not helpful as me trying to jam another time stop in. Whoops. And there they go. Yeah, Sailor Saturn's definitely breaking her back carrying this team. And that looks like another fight. Sorry. Okay, to be fair to what I said last time about Saturn carrying the team, or, you know, 2 minutes ago, Sailor Mini Moon does have the heal, not only with... I might be wrong. She does have the heal with Saturn, she might also have the heal with Mercury. Pluto's time stop is good enough for her. And Mars and Mercury do decent damage after you level them up a bit more than I have them right now. But damn, they're not gonna match Saturn's death ray. And like I said earlier, yeah, you can't miss that crystal point. At each point waits one of the witches 5. This one is Tallulu. Why am I starting at the 3rd witch? Oh well. Tallulu doesn't have much for me to tell, because she only survived about 1 episode. Well, 2 if you count her a little bit at the end of one of Mehmet's episodes. I'll save that bit for Mehmet's, though. It has more to do with Mehmet. So the Witches 5 worked for Professor Tomo. I don't know why they weren't within Professor Tomo's part of the game, but why not? The Witches 5 consisted of Eugeel, Mehmet, Tallulu here, Beirut, or Valulia as she's going to be called when we run into her in this game, and Cyphrine and Petal. For those of you counting, you might have gotten somewhere between 6 or 7 names I just spouted out. Well, there are roughly 5 witches in the Witches 5, but one has kind of multiple personality disorder, and we'll get into that one later today. Today, let's talk about Tallulu. Her main plan was to steal hearts using plants. Kind of was already done a bit, but plants being evil, another general theme of Sailor Moon. kind of failed when she decided to inject one of her plants with the hyper venom, I'm gonna call it, because I don't remember what she called it, to turn it into a super plant. The super plant proceeded to eat her. All while Sailor Moon, Pluto, Mini Moon, and Tuxedo Mask were watching. Kinda dark, but, not really their fault. I'm pretty sure if Sailor Mars was there, I could've given the Sailor Scouts a bit more blame. But you're gonna find that ain't true with a couple of the other deaths of the Witches Five. And needless to say, there were no survivors. That means I got 5 deaths to go through! Yay! When I said earlier that we didn't need any more mirrors of the Sailor Scouts, yeah, the Witches Five is another set. And Tallulu here might not fit in very well using plants, unless you remember that Sailor Jupiter is also wood-themed. Yeah, go figure. Here in the States, the anime shows are more electrical, thunder and storms, but she actually had a bit of plant theme to her in the manga. Which is why I'm wondering why Sailor Mars doesn't just burn through her. Better question is, why am I bothering using Pluto's attacks? Just stop time, honey. I think if there's anything I forgot to mention about Tallulu, that I'm not saving for later. Is she using any special attacks? I haven't noticed her use any yet. Oh, here we go. Yeah, basic illusion stuff. Oh no, Sailor Saturn! She'll kill us all! Run and hide! Sailor Mars is about to die. Let's stop time and handle this out. Actually, come to think about it, I don't think any of the Witches Five have any special attacks in this game that are specific to them, like we saw with the Opposito Sense Scouts. You know, I keep trying to go with the Japanese pronunciation, that's a horrible idea. They're Opposite Scouts. A term I'm actually not gonna have to use again, they're all done, I guess. Thank you. Dear God, I gotta pay attention a bit better. How did this happen? I'm sorry, I zoned out. Oh, and she's dead. Oh, nice. And everyone levels up, except for those two people in the middle. Go figure. I like how she disappears, then talks. So, nope, sorry. Tell Lou, go back to the fate where you get eaten by giant plants. I'm not talking much today, and that's because there's not much to talk about today. Without me sounding gibberishly explaining attacks and how they changed. Apparently, mandala does mean encircle. I learned that one recently. That's kind of cool. Huh. And apparently, I never learned not to try going on autopilot when I just use an attack to drain all my energy. And more life water. You can gain a lot of items from these people, but unfortunately you generally don't get puzzle pieces. Oh, and another fight. Okay, I think I already mentioned this earlier, which is why I'm trying to either shut up or, you know, say something interesting. But I believe Time Stop kind of killed Pluto when she used it, the one time she used it in the anime. It was said that she was forbidden to use it, and she must face judgment for doing it. But oh well. Actually, her garnet orb is the only thing that saved her from one of Tillulu's plants at one point. Oh, come on, one survived? Oh, come on! 33 damage remained? Not even? Well, that won't happen again. You know, looking around for these stupid things probably got me more fights. Like that one there. And it definitely makes me look stupid now that I know what I was looking for. I did kinda wanna see this ability. See, fire and water cancel, so I just wanna see what it does. That wasn't nearly as impressive as I thought it would be. Actually, they do that in one of the anime episodes, combine their attacks. It kinda just turns it into a fire water ball attack. That kills things when it hits it. Well, renders them to that 1 HP for Sailor Moon to remove them. And more leveling up. Here we go. Crystal point number 2, guarded by 2 witches. And this time, we'll defeat you. It's a repeat after me song. Okay, this is Cyphrine and Petal, or Bucciarulo. I'm gonna use ciphering, because I know how to pronounce that. As she introduced herself, one body, two minds. That doesn't explain what you see next, which is two witches in two bodies fighting the four Sailor Scouts. She is the most powerful of the witches five, saved for last, and gets the least screen time. I'm not kidding about this. She dies in half an episode. By her own hand, I might want to add. Her attacks are very powerful, enough to keep the Sailor Scouts on their toes. So they had her shoot herself with her magical energy. I don't know if you can call it one suicide if you're able to clone yourself and your clones shoot themselves. Would that be suicide? Because you would technically be shooting yourself. But... okay, it's like in Mega Man. If Gemini Man could deal his own damage with the Gemini laser, could he... brain failing under logic that I don't have. Anyway, it's the same as those two people in the cave we were facing earlier. Except a little bit more dangerous. You can either focus one, or you can go all out. I don't believe they actually had a plan on stealing, Crystal Hearts at all, actually. Or if they did, I don't remember it. I believe it was the final push, in the final battle, with, the Death Busters. Uh-oh, Mars is down. Which might make Cyphrine, the worst witch? I don't know. Then again, when you see the fate of the other three witches, shooting yourself on accident by using magic that was powerful enough to kill you might not be the worst way to go. If you're going with a targeting approach, I suggest targeting the one with the illusion attack. It gets annoying. Also, why aren't I healing? Okay, you can't target the one with the illusion attack, they both have it. Also, don't forget, one body, two minds. Maybe that's a dub error. Well, no, even that wasn't a dub error. That would make six witches, and the witch is five. Oh well. And it appears Sailor Mercury's illusion wore off. That's good. And it looks like I was right. Her and Rini do have a heal as well. Which is good, now we can counter the whirlwind cut. And not waste Sailor Saturn's energy on healing. Okay, Sailor Mars isn't too bad. does what he does. And time to time stop them, so I can get ready for another wave of attacks. So yeah, basic stuff, clone. Focus the blue one! That's clearly the clone! I think her sugar pink heart attack is doing worse damage now. And thank God Sailor Mars moved her, her target after defeating one of them. That would've been horrible. It would've missed. And drain the energy. Oh, come on, how much longer can this fight last? Already killed half her mind. Oh, and there goes the other half. Three of the five witches are still remaining. Tune in next time.